Hi people, I'm Ngân. I'm a founder of Amosy. Amosy is a blog where you can find all the stuff about sunscreen and skincare. So make sure you visit my blog here and subscribe to my channel so you can see my video every week. Alright, so today the topic that I want to talk about is the three things that you might make mistake about the sunscreen. For those who don't know, Hồ Ngọc Hà is a very famous singer in Vietnam, and she is my childhood. Actually, I grew up listening to her music. I remember there's one song, an MV that she did with Superboy. Oh, it was a mess. I love the song. About a year ago, she launched a cosmetics line. It's called Moi Cosmetics. And here is the video that her testing her cushion.
Thực sự mà nói, khi mà cushion của Hoa được ra mắt hơn 1 năm nay rồi, thì Hà đã sử dụng từ đó cho đến nay. Và Hà skip luôn một cái bước là bước kem chống nắng, bởi vì sao vậy?
Did you hear that? She skipped the sunscreen. Oh my god, okay. Just listen to her why she skipped the sunscreen part.
Trong cái hộp cushion này, thì cái thành phần chính của nó đó chính là kem chống nắng sân phúc. 50 SPF nghĩa là một trong những mức độ mà dành dự cái là nắng cao nhất. 50 SPF thì ít nhất là bạn có thể sử dụng và không cần phải phủ lại trong vòng 5 đến 6 tiếng.
There is two things here that she said that I actually disagree with her. That the first thing that she said that she skipped her sunscreen because her cushion has the SPF 50 in there. Guys, do you guys hear me? Is to achieve the sunscreen that written in the label is SPF 50, you gotta apply a efficient amount of this. There's a lot of people that tells you that the correct amount would be measured by the coin or the teaspoon. So the correct amount that I research and read is the 2 mg per centimeter. So how much is the 2 mg per centimeter? So it's approximately half of the teaspoon for your face and your neck. So it will be around this amount. So I will just demo you. Okay, so this is around of this amount. It's just for your face and your neck. Alright, so let me ask you. Do you think that you will put this amount of the cushion or your BB cream or your compact or your powder to your face? No, you don't want to become a cake. You need this amount to achieve the SPF 50, say, written in the package. So this the same as other cosmetic as well, like BB cream or and CC cream and other cushion. So you will need this amount for your face and your neck to achieve the perfect SPF 50. The second thing you might make mistake about is, well, actually it's more on the advice than a mistake, is that sometimes you choose the wrong sunscreen for your skin type. It means sometimes you choose the sunscreen that would drive your skin out too much, or you choose a sunscreen that will make you have more acne, like blackheads and whiteheads. If you have an acne prone skin, then you might want to choose something like mineral based, for it has zinc oxide and titanium dioxide, and do not have the chemicals UV filters, because they increase the chance of irritation and blocking the pore. Something like this. This one is Ultra MD SPF 41. This is a physical sunscreen. And this one is Blue Laser Sensitive SPF 30. I love them both. It's perfect for acne prone skin, and even sensitive skin can use this also. It won't block your pore. So for those who dry skin, you might want to choose some like mixed sunscreens that has physical UV filters and chemical UV filter as well, or you can choose the chemical UV filter only. It's fine. I love this one, and this the Purito one also. These are a perfect choice for dry skin. This sunscreen will not dry out your skin throughout the day, like a moisturizer for your skin. And when you outside activities like you're sweating, you're swimming, you might want to choose something with this water resistance, like 40 to 80 minutes. And this is 80 minutes. This is Ultra's Dermatologist. This is a bae. It's like my lady jam. It's like I love this one a lot. I'm wearing it outside, whatever. It's just so good. It has 8 UV filters. It is so much. It will just give you a perfect sun protection. This is also a good one. It's the mineral sunscreen for body and the face as well. It's 80 minutes water resistant also. It's Ultra MD, the SPF 47, but it will leave a white cast. Like not much, the texture is really smooth, but it will leave white cast. The final thing is the myth that you think a higher SPF will give you a higher sun protection. is actually really tricky is planning this. It is a yes and it is a no as well. It's not actually completely wrong. Higher SPF does give you higher protection. So I will tell you the yes first and why higher SPF will give you higher protection and it will leave you to the wrong consumption. So for example, you don't usually apply sufficiently sunscreen. Usually, you will apply half of their recommended sunscreen amount to your face or to your body. So maybe you will want to choose a SPF 100 because when you apply half of the amount, it will give you around SPF 50. You actually have more protection than you buy the SPF 50 and then you apply half and then it just only give you SPF 25. So that is something is good about higher SPF. Or sometimes it will also increase the chance of irritation. For some people it might not have, but for some people it does. Let me explain you the no here. Because you apply the higher SPF, it will create a false sense of security. What it means is you have, I apply higher SPF 100, so I can just like go out in the sun, directly in the sun, without any other protection like hats and coat and sunglasses, it's okay. And I don't need to reapply it, I just want to reapply it just one time, because it's like 100, you guys. This is a no-no thing. That's why the higher protection maybe give you a higher burn, give you a higher chance of getting cancer. The second thing that I disagree with Hong of Ha's video is she said that when you apply it, you can just leave it for 5 to 6 hours and not reapply it again. It's actually, you have to reapply it every 2 to 3 hours when you're sweating, when you right to the sun, when you're in the swimming pool. No matter you get the SPF 10, SPF 20, SPF 50, SPF 100, you have to reapply it. You will need to reapply it wherever you feel that you're sweating. And it also depends on the water resistant or not. So if it's not water resistant, the chance that you reapply it is more often when you're sweating, okay? So choose and use the sunscreen based on your purpose, your skin type, and just remember to reapply it. Hey, this is all the stuff that I want to share with you guys today. I hope this information is useful to you guys. And if you like it, please share it because sharing is caring. So I will see you guys in my next video. And I wish you guys have a healthy and glowy skin. I always have a big heart for y'all. Love y'all. To get to you. Cause when you see the sun, I see the moon.